All right, now we're going to go into the basics of geometric tolerancing symbology. So this is called the feature control frame. It really is a great name because you point to a feature, a hole, a slot, a surface, and you want to control it and do it with this frame. So they call it a feature control frame. Now in ISO, they call this thing a tolerance indicator. I don't think as good of a name as feature control frame. But the first compartment here is where you put in one of those 12 geometric characteristics. It's the geometry characteristic of the feature that you want to control. Its position, its flatness, its parallelism. Pick one of those symbols and put it in the front. Then you indicate the shape and size of the tolerance zone. Now the default shape, if you don't have any symbol in here, is going to be two parallel planes. That's the default shape of the tolerance zone in which your surface or center plane has to lie within. Now that also applies to surfaces that are really irregular, like a profile or something, then you have a parallel boundaries, which is like parallel planes. So if you don't want it to be parallel planes default, then you can add the diameter symbol, and that will instead change the tolerance zone to a cylindrical tolerance zone instead. And that's going to be for the axis of the hole or axis of the pin to lie within. So those are your two shapes. Usually it's two parallel planes or a cylindrical zone. The 0.5, you know that's millimeters because of the leading zero. That's going to be the size of that zone, either the size of the cylinder or the distance between your two parallel planes. And then you have your datum reference frame. So you have your primary datum feature, the secondary datum feature, and the tertiary datum feature. Don't ask me why they didn't just say first, second, third, but they used primary, secondary, or tertiary. I guess that sounds more impressive. So that's creating your coordinate system. It's like XYZ of like, you want it positioned relative to what? Relative to this ABC XYZ coordinate system. Now this is a very basic feature control frame here, but they can even get more basic than this. You could have a flatness that only has two compartments, the flatness and the tolerance, and that's it. You can add modifiers. This is a material condition modifier giving you bonus tolerance in some certain applications. You can add between symbols to the extent of the tolerance zone. You can do all around on here. You can add modifiers in the front. You can even add modifiers to the datum features in the back. And of course, we're going to explore all that more later in the section here. But the introduction here, feature control frame, three compartments. What do you want to do? Size and shape of the zone, and relative to what datum reference frame. The tolerance zones, we kind of talked about those. The main shapes are going to be your parallel planes and your cylindrical zones, but there are ways to make spherical zones, concentric cylinders, conical zones, little jelly bean zones, whatever shape you want. There's 3D tolerances that create three-dimensional tolerance zones, and then there's 2D tolerances that create parallel lines instead of planes, circles instead of cylinders. Same thing though. So in the book, I have a chart that shows all the symbols that could be associated with a feature control frame, either found inside or around. And some of them you'll see quite a bit. I bet MMC will be a common one. Diameter symbols are common. And then there's more obscure symbology you don't see as often, like spherical diameter and maybe tangent plane and things like that. So of course, we'll talk about more of these later in the program at their appropriate times. I've also shown when they were introduced or modified. So in 09, these were modified a little bit, especially with the datum features, the MMB and LMB. That was in 09. In 18, we had two new symbols, the dynamic profile and the FROM2. These are probably not very common for most people, but they are for specialized applications you might see them. Also, I have an ISO term. So when there is an ISO term that's somewhat equivalent to the ASME, I try to put those in the list too. You know, we call it maximum material condition in ASME, and ISO, they call it maximum material requirement. Same concept, just different term name. And same thing, we have some symbols in our standard that they don't have in theirs and vice versa. So you'll see that as well. This chart shows the symbols for datum feature identification. This is your more common one here. And that's for Y14.5 and ISO. It's that little suction cup with a flag, and then you put one of your datum feature letters in the top. This is an older symbol for much older drawings, 1982 and earlier. They used to call it with a rectangle and then dashes on either side of the letter, but that's an outdated symbol. Datum targets are another way to identify datum features, specific points rather than the entire surface, and we'll talk about more of that in Unit 8. So just an introduction to some of the feature control frame, and we're going to explore more of that in some other videos here.